quitting is a permanent solution for a temporary problem. Right, that's by Lou Holtz, who is the head coach, most notably for the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. He was known for turning around a lot of college football programs, so he had to push through the hard times when he first got there, because he knew that eventually they would turn things around. And that's the same thing with high school, right? When I would have deadlines and things, if I pushed through, the problem would not be there in the next week, rather than just quitting on it completely.
Hi campers, JC for Council E here. I had a quote that I really want to share with you all. Marilyn Monroe once said, "Everything happens for a reason. People change so you can learn to let go. Things go wrong so that you can appreciate them when they're right. And sometimes good things fall apart so that better things can fall together." Now, this quote is especially pertinent to life inside of the pandemic for all of us. 2020 has brought some major events that honestly none of us could have prepared for. But post-pandemic, when life is a little less chaotic, we'll be far more appreciative of not only the new additions in our lives, but the things that have remained constant in our lives over the years. Marilyn also said, "Sometimes good things fall apart so that better things can fall together." In order to get to the better, to get to the improved, something has to give. Something has to fall apart. Major growth can help us get to the improved, but growth doesn't happen unless you're uncomfortable and a bit out of your element, kind of like being in the middle of a pandemic. So, don't think that that tough day you just had or a season of hardship is completely random, because there is a greater purpose and there is a bigger picture that you haven't been able to see yet. Remember, everything happens for a reason.
My inspirational quote that I've always followed throughout my 4 years of high school is, "The comeback is always stronger than the setback." And with this inspirational quote, you get the feeling that, yes, you will have mistakes throughout your career and life, but the buildup and the comeback is always stronger because you know what's to come. You're prepared and you are ready for the future and whatever obstacles come your way.
My favorite motivational quote is, "Have courage and be kind," from Cinderella. I think especially during these times, we have to have courage, you know, with not knowing what's even gonna happen tomorrow. And especially in student council, you have to have courage that you are leading your entire school. You have to have courage to, you know, bring out new ideas. And it can be scary. So I just think having courage is a really big thing. And also just being kind to one another. I think in this world that there's a lot of negativity, and we just need to be kind to each other, and especially for student council, you are someone who is representing your school, and I think it's important that you treat everyone as you want to be treated and have kindness.
So one of my favorite inspirational quotes is to always lead with love. This is one of my favorites because I think it's so important to show compassion and love to other people, and I think it's genuinely so important to lead by example and show that kindness to other people.
Hi, my name is Lakin, and my favorite quote is, "You make a life out of what you have and not what you're missing." Because if we're always constantly upset about what we're missing, then we're never looking forward to what we have, instead of just making, like, going with the flow, kind of like what you have and being grateful for that. And so it's helped me in hard times, just knowing that I have a lot more opportunities to come and this isn't going to affect me in 5 minutes, let alone 5 years. So I just need to keep pushing through.
I'm Riley, I'm the proud JC of Council J, and my favorite motivational quote is, "Take it one day at a time and you'll be fine." This is because the one day at a time can be replaced with anything, one step at a time, one person at a time, like just take it one by one, and everything will end up working out in the end. It's worked for almost everything that's got me to this point in my life. I just gotta take it one step at a time and it'll be fine.
our mental health tip for the day is really just a day to detox, right? So whatever that you do that makes you feel, you know, that gets you alone with your thoughts and allows you to think things through, like reading or driving around and listening to music or you know, just whatever helps you through the day, do that, and that will definitely help.
As a leader, that buildup in your life can occur at a quicker rate than some others. And so I think that a day to detox whenever you can, whenever you have a day off, is a great idea. So everyone has a different way of detoxing. Some people may prefer to do their day to detox by themselves, or maybe they detox better around people or with people. But whatever you do, a few tips for going into your day to detox would be: put your phone on Do Not Disturb or turn it off completely, because you want to reduce how often you're exposing yourself to your screen. Also, if you are more of an organized person, I would suggest making a schedule. I actually put together a schedule that I'll share. Here's an example of what a day to detox could look like for you. As you can see, I have a very early wake-up call, just because the night before I went to bed pretty early, so I had about 8 to 9 hours of sleep. For breakfast, I decided that I was gonna have some avocado toast and scrambled egg whites, just pretty healthy food for the morning. But I decided to be really specific about that because I didn't want it to take away from my face mask and reading time. My favorite part about my schedule would have to be the journaling at the lake, just because it gives me time to really be by myself. So basically, my note appreciation activity is just time out of my day where I sit down and write mini notes to people in my life who have really impacted me or continue to inspire me. Next, I have a nap, dinner with my family, and at the end of the day, I always choose to do a self-improvement reflection, and then I go to bed. Whenever you choose to do your day to detox, make sure that you have no responsibilities or no obligations on that day, which means that you should be able to allow your day to flow the way you would like to, and that you're not being rushed in any way to maybe complete a task or anything. If you're unsure about what direction you would like to go in for your day to detox, you could also theme your day. This means that you can dedicate your day to learning about an object or a topic or a situation that you've always been interested in but you've never had much time to research on. However you choose to spend your day to detox, just know that it is entirely okay to remain in a state of passiveness throughout the day. You don't have to do much, but as long as you feel like you're getting the needed rest, then you're spending the day just right.